It is day four for Crazy Quilty March. I'm Pat Sloan, and you are here in my studio where we are going to talk about prompt number four for my month-long 31-day video series about getting in touch with your quilting, touching it literally every single day. That's what our goal is. So today's prompt, if you have your handy dandy calendar that you can download from my website, it is tidying up. And that's something I've talked about for a while. We did a whole sort of series of that in my Facebook community. I think it was in January or maybe last year sometime, where being sure that you leave your space where it's tidy, so when you come back the next day, it is not a big freaking mess, and that you don't really feel motivated because you can't find the pattern and you can't find the fabric, and you know, it's just not, you know, not a pleasant place to work. But I want to focus the tidying up today for the challenge. Yes, it'd be nice to, you know, when you leave tonight from your workspace, be sure that it's ready for you to work the next day. You know, so, you know, make your work surface a little bit clear, get things where you can find it again. If you sort of toss stuff around, maybe just stack it up so at least it's not, you know, visually such a mess when you come in. But I want to focus because I'd like you to find one place to do a little bit more focused tidying up. It's overwhelming to do your entire environment at once. I've done it many times. I do it a lot because I have things come in and come out because it's a business and it gets a little bit crazy. So like on our day one, I focused just on the office assistant, the rolling cart. But today, this tidying up, that was more like getting an office assistant to help you, you know, focus where your things are. Today is really picking a point that needs to be cleared up. You might have a stack on the floor of things that you have not gotten to. You've put it there, you're like, yeah, I need to get it away. For me, I'm gonna show you this in a second. This is my nemesis. This is my area. Do you see why I have the cute little tulip quilt there? There's a reason. But find some place in your studio. It might be you have one of your fabric bins that every time you go to it, it is like an explosion. The stuff just needs to be taken out and refolded, which seriously will probably take you 10 minutes. It doesn't ever really take as long as you think it will. Dump that bin out, refold everything. You might have your threads. Maybe you're doing the cross stitch and you've just been tossing colors in there and now they're, you know, all jumbled up. Dump it out, sort it, put it back neat and tidy. Maybe on your work surface, you can't even see the work surface. You can't find your cutting mat, therefore you can't start a project, therefore it doesn't feel fun to do this. Get that work surface cleared off. Find one thing, and at the end of the day, tidy up. And I will put the challenge out that every day you tidy up when you leave your space in March. From here on out, for the month of March, just be sure you take a little second, you know, think, what would Pat do? Yeah, tidy up, because it makes a huge difference when you come down and come into the space in the morning. So let me show you what's going on here. I have pinned this up here. It's not like, it doesn't look that messy, probably to you. It looks like, because they're all in bins. So I have all these bins. And what's going on though, is these are things that, you know, I get these collections in to work with, and they're very yummy and they're wonderful, but I'm not at this point working with some of these. And so I have to make a decision. Do I undo the bundles? Do I go and put this, like this is aqua, like this aqua fabric. Do I go and put the aqua fabric in the aqua fabric bin so I can use it for something else? Because I keep all my bins by color. And I've got three of these. I've got one, two, three. No, I lied. I have four. I've got four of these that are just filled with fabric that I had gotten to work with or had come in from a manufacturer, and I haven't, they didn't get used, okay? That's basically the bottom line. They didn't get used. So I had to make a decision. How do I want to store those? Plus, I have the top shelf here. Let's roll it on up. So it doesn't look messy, but there's a bunch of little junk on the top shelf. There's little stuff that I just need to move. Do you want to see my camera? This is my grandfather's brownie. Isn't that glorious? We did pictures with it. Greg developed the film. I love having it in here. I have it on this really cute little pedestal, like a little bitty cake stand. Those things make me happy. I have some things that make me happy. I have a little bitty sewing machine up there, and an old baby, like an iron. I have some gnomes. They're white at the very top. Up there. So anyways, I digress. This is what happens, right? When we go to tidy up, it's like, oh, what is that? So I need to get the little stuff put away. I have a bunch of binding there. I just like binding strips, and I have some other ones. I need to like sew them all together for a scrappy binding, for a scrappy quilt. And then I need these four bins. I need to go through them and decide. I mean, some of them may go back in here. They may stay here. But there are ones in there that I know for what I have coming up right now, I'm not going to be using them. They didn't fit the project, or they're for way future. So they need to go into their forever home, which is in the bins. You know, so my bins are by color, and that would be a discussion for another day. So thank you so much for following along with my crazy quilty march. I am so glad that you're here. I love you. You are doing amazing things. Please show your quilts. Show me pictures, or tell me what you're going to do. If you're in a place like YouTube where you can't show me a picture, put a note down there. Leave me a comment. Tell me what area you will tackle today. Okay? You ready? Ready, set, go. See you online.